everyone, in today's video I will be discussing about battery. What is battery? Purposely touching or applying force on other persons or things related to the person without his consent with the intention to harm the person is known as a battery. It is also considered when there is an actual physical contact without the consent of the person to harm the person. Generally, assault is followed by the battery, which is the reason assault and battery are mostly used together. The battery is often considered as trespass to a person, so it is divided into two types. First is the criminal battery and second is the civil battery. What do you mean by criminal battery? Criminal battery is also known as the battery as a crime. Whenever there is an intention to kill a person or to hurt the person with an offensive physical contact is considered as battery of crime. In a criminal battery, intention plays a major role as the action involves intention to kill a person. Civil battery. Civil battery is also known as the battery as a tort because it is a civil wrong. When a person has no intention to hurt someone but commits an act which hurts another person and the wrongdoer has an idea that the act will hurt another person is known as a civil battery. As the battery is considered as an intentional tort, but in the civil battery the intention to hurt someone is not present. So the victim can lodge a complaint against the wrongdoer under the civil court. Essentials of the battery. First essential of the battery is intention. The intentions for both civil battery and criminal battery are different. Criminal intent to cause the injury is not necessary, but the intention to cause the act which harms the person is required, as it results in the battery. The intent of the battery is transferable, as when a person tries to hit a person without his consent and he ends up hitting a different person, but the person is still liable for the battery. So the intention is the soul of battery and is very essential. Contact or use of force is necessary for committing a battery. Harm through the force is not basic requirement, but the use of force is the basic requirement to conduct battery. It is not necessary that the contact must be physical or individual, but the physical contact through indirect ways is also considered as a physical contact, as the use of sticks or spitting on someone is also considered as a battery. Harming the people with changing the heat, odor, light is also considered as battery. The battery doesn't need body-to-body contact, as the battery can also be for future events, which means if there is a delay between the accused actions and the injury of the complainant will still be a battery. Damage is necessary for the completion of the battery. Damage can be of any kind. It can be physical, mental or emotional. Battery is not limited to physical damage only. The victim must have suffered in any manner, but the harm can be minimum. Severe damages are not required. Unwanted sexual contact or uncomfortable touching without the consent is also comes under the battery, as it harms the person physically, emotionally and mentally as well. No consent. The victim must know about the action which is planned by the accused. The battery is only committed when the victim has no idea about the contact which was going to happen. For example, when surgeons steal organs from patients to sell them will be considered as a battery. And when the doctor, while doing a surgery, finds that the appendix in the body will cause some trouble during the surgery and the doctor informs the patient that he is going to remove the appendix, in this situation, the doctor is not liable for the battery as there was a consent of patient involved. Thank you.